thinking I'm out of my mind. 'Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all.
Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Okay, I missed you guys. Did you miss us? Tink right now is with her dad, so yeah, but by the time I put this out, she'd probably be back with me. I don't know, but without further ado, I'm tweaking, but today will be my labor and delivery story. Okay, so yeah, without further ado, let's get into the video.
Okay.
So, as you guys know, I had Jada on November 4th of 2018 at 1:35 p.m. So, I'll go into labor, okay? Well, I started labor, put that way. Starting labor and going into labor means when you're dilated. When you start to dilate and when you start to have contractions, that's going into labor. That's labor, okay? So not just going to the hospital, that's delivery. But your labor starts when you start dilating and when you start having contractions, okay? I want your water break, I think. Just know. So yeah. So I'll get done with school on the 2nd, take my finals for the trimester on the 2nd, or whatever. And so that week, I was 38 weeks in. Yeah, I probably just hit 38 weeks. So I go to the doctor, and then she was like, okay, yeah, you're 1 centimeter dilated. And I'm just like, whoa. Because we was talking about, getting induced because I did not want to go to the 9th. I was tired. I was full term, and it was just too much. And I was like, yeah, I'm not gonna go to the 9th. Definitely not. I was supposed to get induced that Tuesday. Okay? That Tuesday. Because I wanted to have Jada on the 7th, but obviously Jada had other plans. She could have told me about it. She could have told me about it, y'all. Like, anywho, so, where was I at? So the doctor was like, yeah, hopefully you're going to labor this weekend. And started laughing. I'm just like, yeah, hopefully I don't. Like, you could have just told me, doc, like, I was going to labor this weekend. Like, you could have just told me. You don't have to say, I hope you don't go to labor this weekend. Like, girl, just be straight up with me, poo-poo. Ain't nothing but a thing, jiggle. Anywho, so it's that Friday. I get done with everything. And also me and my friend, we had gotten into it that week because I went to buy a bag of hot chips. And so I was like, okay, I'm gonna buy a bag of hot chips. And this was at lunchtime. And she was like, no, you can't buy them. So I was gonna eat them. Yeah, I haven't had spicy foods in like 6 months since I found out I was pregnant. No, I found out I was pregnant at 2 months going on 3. Yeah, so about 6 months I've had any hot chips or anything. So I'm like, okay, you know, full time, I'm finna go have this baby Tuesday. So like, I'm finna finish with school. And a little bag of hot chips won't hurt. And y'all, me and her got into it. When I said we got into it, we freaking got into it. That's my girl to this day. But look, I was pregnant and I wanted some hot chips. And I was like, I'm gonna give me these hot chips. Or whatever. So we start tug war for the bag. I'm just like, give me the hot chips. She's like, no, you're gonna induce your labor. No, you're not having these hot chips, not eating. So I'm just like, I'm gonna eat these hot chips if I want to eat these hot chips. Like, you're not gonna stop me. I'm gonna live my best life and eat these hot chips. And she was like, watch, we ain't going to labor. Don't say nothing. Don't say I didn't warn you. So I go to class, you know, not thinking too much about it. I'm just like, okay, been having my best time eating hot chips. And so I'm just smacking, just, ooh, living my best life eating them hot chips. So, and then that week passed, so the third Saturday, I start feeling contractions. At first, they was irregular, like maybe 1 hour passed, and then you know another hour passed, and it was around really like 5-6 o'clock when it started really getting down, and so I start getting contractions around 6 every 10 minutes. And then, so when it hit 7, it was every 7 minutes, and then every 5 minutes. It is, my mom, she's just calling people, and she's just like, do I go to the hospital? Like, what do I do? She's having contractions. It's like, yeah, go to the hospital. Because that was same week. Yeah, I thought my water broke the same week, but it was just pee. I was too big. And, you know, I said big. When you're full term and your baby's sitting on your bladder, you're going to leak a little. Just FYI, if y'all trying to get pregnant and y'all watching this, when you get full term, you're gonna leak a little, so just have some pads, but y'all wear something, because I did it. But so we go to the hospital, they check me, and they're like, well, you're around 4 centimeters. And I'm just like, because just last week I was 1 centimeter. Right, just beginning of that week, I was just 1 centimeter. Now I'm 4 centimeters. Where is time going? But then I have to think about it. I was full term, and my classes were so far apart. So I'm just walking daily walking. Cause when you walk a lot, that helps start your labor. That helps bring the baby down. And then I ate some hot chips. So I partially blame the hot chips, but I was being hard-headed. So God was like, yay, finna have this baby because it should be hard-headed. He was like, you don't want to listen to nobody. She clearly telling you not to eat the hot chips, but you ate them anyway? Oh, yeah. You finna go into labor, baby. You finna have this baby, baby. So after that happened. It is so, you know, so crazy. That Saturday, when I went to labor, I made this post. I'm going to put it right here. I made this post. And I was like, when my baby is born, don't claim her as your niece or whatever. We have nothing to do with her. You know? I hate that. People do that all the time. And I be like, yo. But you know, it don't be my place to say nothing. Because I didn't let nobody post Jada for the first month because that's what everybody was expecting. So I'm like, yeah, I'm not gonna post her. It worked out in my favor though. Anywho, so we get to the hospital. She checked me. She's like, you're 4 centimeters. You're staying. And I'm just like, oh my gosh. Y'all, my emotions was I was scared. I was tired. I was happy. I was sad. I was nervous. I'm like, because you know, I never had a baby before. So I don't know what's gonna happen. You know, I never had a baby. I'm just like, oh my gosh. Is this real? Like, am I really about to have a freaking baby? Like, I'm really finna push this girl out my vagina. I really am. Like, oh my gosh. It is. So my mama, she had to drive 2 hours to come see me and stay with me. And then my sister was gonna pick up my grandma. So we y'all just waiting. I'm just having contractions. I'm just like, ooh. And y'all, I'm just like, I'm procrastinating. I'm progressing so fast because they came and checked me every 2 hours. And it was like, okay, well, now you're at 5. Now you're at 6. Now you're at 7. Now you're at 8. So around 8 o'clock, mind you. I said 8 o'clock. Mind you, all of this happens around 10 o'clock now when I was 7 centimeters. So they come back at midnight on the 4th. And they was like, what they say? Yeah, I'm so... And so they checked me. I was like, yeah, you're 8 centimeters. So mind you, I just started having contractions at 6 o'clock. And within the span of 6 hours, I was almost done. I'm just like, but I asked, because I didn't want to do epidural. They asked me like, do you want an epidural? I'm just like, no, because I heard that if you get epidural, you're going to have back pain. And people tell me that all the time. And I'm just like, first of all, don't want back pain. Second of all, too young for back pain. And third of all, I'm scared of needles. So I'm just like, yeah, no, I'm okay. I'm not gonna get that big, dumb needle stuck into me when I can't do the pain myself. Okay. So, I mean, the contractions, they didn't really hurt. I could say they was hurting that. They didn't really hurt me. So I'm just like, okay. But I need epidural for one. It's just a hard cramp. So, I asked, they gave me some other IV meds. They gave me like 2 milliliters, I think. Was it the milliliters? Yeah. 2 milliliters. It started with a D, I believe. I just remember it because it's just been so long. Because I just went to sleep that night, y'all. I just went to sleep that night because I was tired. These contractions just kept coming. And what that pain medicine did, it basically like stopped. It stopped my contractions. It made the pain very dull. Like, I didn't really feel it. It's like almost numbed it. You can still get contractions, like still feel them, but just not as much as you normally would. So I was high as a kite. I'm not gonna lie, I was baked as a pie. I was high. Okay, and then so they came back and checked on me, and it's like, okay, well, you're still at 8 centimeters. Mind you, this around. When is around? This around 2 o'clock in the morning. So I'm like, oh, okay, cool. And then so around 6 o'clock, they come back and check me again, and they like, yeah, you're still 8 centimeters dilated. And then around 8 o'clock, Okay, y'all, I'm back. Okay, so yeah. Okay, so yeah. So around 8 o'clock in the morning, they come and they check me. Oh, that's my phone. And they like, you know, you still at 8 centimeters dilated. I'm just like, oh, okay. And then so they was like, by then the drug has wore off, so I'm just like, okay, cool. And so, I can't even think. So, I just get a jacuzzi. You know, that jacuzzi, y'all, felt so good. Like, if they ask, they got a jacuzzi, get in it, okay? I didn't do the yoga box because that wasn't for me. I don't know, but if y'all wanted the yoga box, I'll go ahead and do the yoga box. That's up to y'all. It just wasn't for me. I didn't feel like... What happened if I would have fell off that yoga ball? And I hit my baby. No. So I was like, yeah, no, I'm okay. And so they gave me plenty of apple juice, plenty of water. And I was just living my best life. And y'all, the jacuzzi. The jacuzzi, it helps soothe the contractions. So if you just sit there and you breathe through it. It felt a little bit better. Okay. I'm sorry, y'all. I don't know what's going on with me. But, so after that, around 11-ish, 12-ish, they like, you know, you still at 8 centimeters. So, we're just going to give you pentotocin. Not that much. They gave me 2 milliliters. Instead of, because they was like, you're stuck here, so we just gonna give you that boost so you can finish, so you can have this baby. And then, so I'm like, okay. I'm like, cool. So I get the pentotocin, and, oh, my nurse come in. That's what I forgot. My nurse come in, okay? She comes in around 8 o'clock in the morning. Because, you know, even my water still didn't break yet. And so she come in. She's like, oh, my gosh, your water just so gushy. And she went like, dude. And it broke. It just took her 2 fingers. And it broke. I'm just like, oh my gosh. And it was like, now you're going to start feeling real contractions. I don't know what real contractions is because the contractions still felt the same. So I'm just like, what's real about it? So after that, what happened after that? Yeah, so they give me pentotocin, and then I get back in the jacuzzi. I walk around, no, just do the regular labor stuff. And then so around 1:10-ish, I'm like, ooh, I got to push. And so I had this much of the mucus stuff, I think. My cervix, that's what it is. That's what's my cervix stuff. So they just took their finger and just went like this because it stretched. While they was doing that, they was getting the stuff and still stretching it out. my little hole out. Y'all, when I tell y'all, I get so tired. People sticking their fingers up me, bro. I'm just like, bro, like, stop. I just got so tired of it. Just, I hate that. That's the one thing I hate about being pregnant. Like, they stick their fingers up you, and it just, I hate getting stuff stuck up me doing while I'm pregnant. Okay. I hate it. That makes me really like, don't want any kids in the future. That made me realize, like, is it really worth it? I don't know. But, so, they could get the doctor because I didn't have my doctor because my doctor came on Wednesdays and it was a Sunday. So, it was around 1:10-ish and I started to push. She was like, come on, push. Come on, push. And so, I'm pushing. It was like, do you want to record your labor? I'm just like, nah, I want a video recorded. I'm okay. And then, so, she was like, so I'm pushing. And then she was like, do you want to see what you're doing? And I'm just like, okay, yeah. And so she get a little mirror and she hold it so I can see the baby head, Jada's head. And I push and I saw all that blood. I saw hair, blood, all that. And she was just so white, y'all. She was so pale. And I was like, oh my gosh. I was like, oh my gosh. But it was a beautiful thing. I love it. You know, when babies, their skin tone don't come in immediately. While you're still pushing them out, their skin tone don't come in. So, yeah. But after that, she, what else happened? So, I'm pushing. And then, so, just like, give me one big push. I'm like, and her, I started screaming, y'all, I promise. Because that whole time while I was having contractions, I did not scream. I just breathed through it. And so, I stopped pushing. It's like, what are you doing? Start pushing. I was like, no, it burned. And he's like, oh, yeah, you're just tearing. And my nurse, my labor nurse, she's like, you're just tearing. You know, keep pushing. If you got to scream through it. So, I'm like, ah. And then, so after that, I pushed her head out. Everything else was pretty cool. And now I felt as if when I was pushing the rest of her body, y'all, it didn't hurt. But I felt like I wanted to scream because I felt like I have not screamed the whole while I was in labor. You know, while I was at the hospital delivering, I have not screamed. And only screamed when I pushed her head out. So I just felt as if I wanted to scream for I wanted to scream. And then this one raggedy nurse will talk about, shh. My girlfriend's like, who? Where did you even come from? I don't even know you. She was like, don't scream. I'm like, sis, do you want to fight? Because I don't even know you for real. Like, I don't even know you. Like, who are you? You're just a nurse. And my mama, she kind of cussed her out. She was like, yeah, you can scream if you want to scream. I'm just like, because she must ain't got no kids. I'm convinced. She ain't got no types of kids, okay? Because if she did, she'd understand. Unless she got a C-section or an epidural. Okay? So, that's when Jada was born at 135. Jada Mai Rose Adams was born. And she weighed 6 pounds, 13 ounces. And that was just the most happiest moment of because my baby's here. Like, just going those 9 months that I seen her face and let her grow inside me, it was just really special. I just love that moment, and I'll forever cherish that moment. I will cherish her forever because that's my baby, that's my world. And then, so after that, they was like, are you breastfeeding or no? They cleaned her off first, and they was like, are you breastfeeding or are you bottle feeding? And I'm just like, I'm nursing, and then so they was like, oh, okay. And they put it to the boob. That whole day was just pain. Like, her getting on my boob just hurted so much because I didn't rough up my nipples. I didn't know nothing about roughing up your nipples. I didn't know nothing about it. And it just, dog, it hurt it. And I'm just like, oh my gosh. And just like, I just can't get enough of this pain. Like, I just had a freaking baby. And this stuff really gotta hurt. Really? So I just took it like a G though. I was like, I just breathed through that too. In the first 6 weeks, or 6 weeks of my life, the pain was just ridiculous. But yeah, and then so she got done eating. They washed. It's all just holding her, and then they come in a day later, and it's like, well, you guys gotta stay extra. Well, they was like, you guys don't have to stay, because Jada had jaundice. They told us she had jaundice. And it was like, Jada's admitted to the hospital, but, if you guys want to leave, you can leave. And I'm just like, I'm definitely not going nowhere with my baby. Because I just had her. Y'all not finna know. I will stay here, and I will buy my own food. If that's the case, I will buy my own food. I don't care about that. And so, They start testing for jaundice, and then when her jaundice was bad, it wasn't really bad at all. She just had a trait of it, and they just want to fix it. They just want to type and to prevent it from getting really bad. Okay, and then so we was there. We were supposed to leave. I had her Sunday, and we left on Wednesday. We were supposed to leave. I think that Monday. Okay, y'all, I'm back. Okay, so yeah. Okay, so yeah. So around 8 o'clock in the morning, they come and they check me. Oh, that's my phone. And they like, you still at 8 centimeters, dilated. I'm just like, oh, okay. And then so they was like, by then the drug has. By then, the drug has wore off, so I'm just like, okay, cool. And so, I can't even think. So, I just get a jacuzzi. That jacuzzi, y'all, felt so good. Like, if they ask, they got a jacuzzi, get in it, okay? I didn't do the yoga box because that wasn't for me. I don't know, but if y'all wanted the yoga box, I'll go ahead and do the yoga box. That's up to y'all. It just wasn't for me. I didn't feel like... What happened if I would have fell off that yoga ball? And I hit my baby. No. So I was like, yeah, no, I'm okay. And so they gave me plenty of apple juice, plenty of water. And I was just living my best life. And y'all, the jacuzzi. The jacuzzi, it helps soothe the contractions. So if you just sit there and you breathe through it. It felt a little bit better. Okay. I'm sorry, y'all. I don't know what's going on with me. But, so after that, around 11-ish, 12-ish, they like, you still at 8 centimeters. So, we're just going to give you pentotocin. Not that much. They gave me 2 milliliters. Instead of, because they was like, you're stuck here, so we just gonna give you that boost so you can finish, so you can have this baby. And then, so I'm like, okay. I'm like, cool. So I get the pentotocin, and, oh, my nurse come in. That's what I forgot. My nurse come in, okay? She comes in around 8 o'clock in the morning. Because, my water still didn't break yet. And so she come in. She's like, oh, my gosh, your water just so gushy. And she went like, dude. And it broke. It just took her 2 fingers. And it broke. I'm just like, oh my gosh. And it was like, now you're going to start feeling real contractions. I don't know what real contractions is because the contractions still felt the same. So I'm just like, what's real about it? So after that, what happened after that? Yeah, so they give me pentotocin, and then I get back in the jacuzzi. I walk around, no, just do the regular labor stuff. And then so around 1:10-ish, I'm like, ooh, I gotta push. And so I had this much of the mucus stuff, I think. My cervix, that's what it is. That's what's my cervix stuff. So they just took their finger and just went like this, because it stretched. While they was doing that, they was getting the stuff and still stretching it out. My little hole out. Y'all, When I tell y'all, I get so tired. People sticking their fingers up me, bro. I'm just like, bro, like, stop. I just got so tired of it. Just, I hate that. That's the one thing I hate about being pregnant. Like, they stick their fingers up you, and it just, I hate getting stuff stuck up me doing while I'm pregnant. Okay. I hate it. That makes me really like, don't want any kids in the future. That made me realize, like, is it really worth it? I don't know. But, so, they could get the doctor because I didn't have my doctor because my doctor came on Wednesdays and it was a Sunday. So, it was around 1:10-ish and I started to push. She's like, come on, push. Come on, push. And so, I'm pushing. It was like, do you want to record your labor? I'm just like, nah, I want a video recorded. I'm okay. And then, so, she was like, so I'm pushing. And then she was like, do you want to see what you're doing? And I'm just like, okay, yeah. And so she get a little mirror. And she hold it so I can see the baby head, Jada's head. And I push and I saw all that blood. I saw hair, blood, all that. And she was just so white, y'all. She was so pale. And I was like, oh my gosh. I was like, oh my gosh. But it was a beautiful thing. I love it. You know, when babies, their skin tone don't come in immediately. While you're still pushing them out, their skin tone don't come in. So, yeah. But after that, she, what else happened? So, I'm pushing it in. So, just like, give me one big push. I'm like, and her, I started screaming, y'all, I promise. Because that whole time while I was having contractions, I did not scream. I just breathed through it. And so, I stopped pushing. It's like, what are you doing? Start pushing. I was like, no, it burned. And he's like, oh, yeah, you're just tearing. And my nurse, my labor nurse, she's like, you're just tearing. You know, keep pushing. If you got to scream through it. So, I'm like, ah. And then, so after that, I pushed her head out. Everything else was pretty cool. And now I felt as if when I was pushing the rest of her body, y'all, it didn't hurt. But I felt like I wanted to scream because I felt like I have not screamed the whole while I was in labor. You know, while I was at the hospital delivering, I have not screamed. And only screamed when I pushed her head out. So I just felt as if I wanted to scream for I wanted to scream. And then this one raggedy nurse will talk about, shh. My girlfriend's like, who? Where did you even come from? I don't even know you. She was like, don't scream. I'm like, sis, do you want to fight? Because I don't even know you for real. Like, I don't even know you. Like, who are you? You're just a nurse. And my mama, she kind of cussed her out. She was like, Mimi, yeah, you can scream if you want to scream. I'm just like, because she must ain't got no kids. I'm convinced. She ain't got no types of kids, okay? Because if she did, she'd understand. Unless she got a C-section or an epidural. Okay? So, that's when Jada was born at 135. Jada Mai Rose Adams was born. And she weighed 6 pounds, 13 ounces. And that was just the most happiest moment of because my baby's here. Like, just going those 9 months that I seen her face and let her grow inside me, it was just really special. I just love that moment, and I'll forever cherish that moment. I will cherish her forever because that's my baby, that's my world. And then, so after that, they was like, are you breastfeeding or no? They cleaned her off first, and he's like, are you breastfeeding or are you bottle feeding? And I'm just like, I'm nursing, and then, so they was like, oh, okay. And they put it to the boob. That whole day was just pain. Like, her getting on my boob just hurted so much because I didn't rough up my nipples. I didn't know nothing about roughing up your nipples. I didn't know nothing about it. And it just, dog, it hurt it. And I'm just like, oh my gosh. And just like, I just can't get enough of this pain. Like, I just had a freaking baby. And this stuff really gotta hurt. Really? So I just took it like a G though. I was like, oh. I just breathed through that too. In the first 6 weeks, for 6 weeks of my life. The pain was just ridiculous. But yeah, and then so she got done eating. They washed. It's all just holding her, and then they come in a day later, and it's like, well, you know, you guys gotta stay extra. Well, they was like, you guys don't have to stay, because Jada had jaundice. They told us she had jaundice. And it was like, Jada's admitted to the hospital, but, you know, if you guys want to leave, you can leave. And I'm just like, I'm definitely not going nowhere with my baby. Because I just had her. Y'all not finna know. I will stay here, and I will buy my own food. If that's the case, I will buy my own food. I don't care about that. And so, they start testing for jaundice, and then when like her jaundice was bad, it wasn't really bad at all. That's, you know, she just had a trait of it, and they just want to fix it. They just want to type and to prevent it from getting really bad. Okay, and then so we was there. We were supposed to leave. I had her Sunday, and we left on Wednesday. We were supposed to leave. I think that Monday. Yeah, we were supposed to leave Monday. So, yeah, I remember this one time she was in this box, right? Because when the baby has jaundice, they give him a Billy Ray light, which is, I said Billy Ray, I don't forget what it's called. Maybe it's called that. I just put a picture of it right here. Check out. Yeah, you're supposed to leave Monday. So, yeah, I remember this one time she was in this box, right? Because when the baby has jaundice, they give him a Billy Ray light, which is, I said Billy Ray, I don't forgot what it's called. Maybe it's called that. Talking about. And so they gotta have that around them, okay? And so I mean, when I was able to hold her at first, when I had the little blanket, that blanket was freaking big as ever. And so I was able to hold her and still feed her or whatever. And then they put her in a NICU box in my room. And not being able to hold your child hurts. That hurt my soul because I want to hold her. You know, I want to love on her. I just had her and I can't even hold her. And I remember she was hiccuping this one time. And I was like, cause she was so skinny, y'all. So when the baby hiccups, it looked like the chest is caving in. And so I was like, Mama Jay, the chest is caving in. She's like, what? It's a hair across the nurse, and then Mama was like, those are just hiccups. And I was just crying. So then the nurse came in, and she opened the little box and let me hold her. And I was just holding her to my heart, and I was like, baby, I did not want to let her go, y'all. I'm just like, she has to be healthy. I mean, she was healthy, but she had to just get rid of jaundice, you could say. And that was really hurt. That really hurt my heart. Like, I never want to be in that type of pain ever again. It was just too much. Yeah, I was just so depressed in the hospital. So I lost about a good 20 pounds. So I was just so depressed. Like, I would barely eat anything. You know, I was just so depressed because it was nurses that were coming in and out. And they had to give me a stool softener, and they had to make sure I pee, make sure I showered okay. It was just a lot. And after having that baby, y'all insides, if y'all pregnant, it's gonna feel like it's gonna fall out. It's just gonna feel like it's gonna. So I hated walking around because I'm like, oh my gosh, my insides just gonna fall out of my body. Like, do I gotta pick them up? But yeah, I was just so depressed in the hospital, y'all. I really was. I just wanted to go home. I wanted to go home. So yeah, that pretty much was it. Don't forget anything, Emma. Yeah, that's pretty much was it. Like I said, I'm put the little blanket right there. And yeah, so when I get home, my baby daddy texted me, y'all. It was that Sunday. When she was a week old. It was that Sunday, and he texted me. I was feeding Jada, and I was nursing, and so I wasn't on my phone at the time. And so my best friend got my Instagram on her phone, and so she called me. She FaceTimed me. I'm just like, not for the answer. She probably don't want nothing. And then so she called my mama, and I'm just like, what's her middle name? I'm just like, girl. And so she was like, oh my gosh, your baby daddy texted me, oh my gosh. I'm just like, yeah, because I was doing it alone for 6 months straight. So I just got pretty much used to doing it alone. I mean, it wasn't nothing bad when he texted me. I was just surprised because, y'all, from the way he was acting, I really didn't expect him to text me. You know, I didn't really expect him to come around, honestly. I was like, okay, I'm just going to do it by myself. Hard lesson learned, you know? But, yeah, so at first he was like, send me a picture of the baby. And I was going to send him a picture because, like I told y'all, I did not post Jada for her first month of life. I did not post her. And then, so he was like, send me a picture of the baby. And I was going to send him a picture, block and delete. Like, what's there to talk about? Okay, y'all, I'm back. So, he texted me. He was like, send me a picture of the baby. So, I was just going to send him a picture. As I told y'all, she was not on my page yet. I didn't post her yet or anything. And so, can you think? So, I was going to send a picture, block and delete. Oh, no. I was like, because I didn't want to talk to him. I'm just like, you just freaking abandoned me. I was still hurt. You know, I was really hurt. I'm like, you just abandoned me for 6 months. I'm like, you're about to talk to the girls then. You know, talk to them about your child, you know. And so, I was still really hurt. So, I was just going to block and delete and just call it a day and wait till I see him in child support court. You know, but mom was like, don't do that. Tell him that if you want to see the baby, you gotta come over and see the baby. I'm just like, oh my gosh. I'm like, okay, I just text him. I'm like, and then so, because y'all, I just at the time, I want him to feel the pain I felt. But I just really want him to feel the pain I felt. I want him to feel the hurt I felt. So I just figured if I just block and delete him, then he gonna have to find some type of way to get in contact with me because I was not about to contact him anymore because, it was just so much. I was just really, really hurt. I was hurt and I just felt so stupid. I'm just like, it was just a lot, okay? It was a really lot of feelings that went into it. So, you know, so he came over and his first time when he came over, like, I did not talk to him at all. I was like, this is what we're saying, talking about. He hurt me so bad. He just hurt me so bad. He just make me, just him not being there for me. And I mean, well, not for me, just for the baby. It just makes me, he made me not want to have any more kids. Put it that way. He makes me not want to have any more kids because I don't want to feel the pain I felt. Okay. I don't want to feel that pain I felt at all. Not again. Especially as I get older because I'm definitely look more stupid. So I already look stupid from having a baby in high school and you're not talking to me. He just made me not want to have any more kids. Put it that way. So, after that, once he came over, I'm like, because he came over and I didn't talk to him. I didn't even look at him. I was on my phone the whole time. I'm like, because there's nothing for us to talk about. But, because y'all went to cuss him out so bad. I promise I did. But I'm like, why? I just figured. I don't know. It was just a lot of emotions going towards that. It did, so once he came over, because I keep getting off track, once he came over and hugged Jada for the first time, y'all, he just fell in love. You could tell. You could tell because he came in, man. Yes. But yeah, once he came over and hugged Jada for the first time, he fell in love. Like, you can tell. Like, and that's why I didn't really cuss him out. Because he fell in love with Jada, and he been around ever since. So that's why I didn't really cuss him out or anything. But yeah, so that was my labor and delivery story. I was in labor for a total of 18 hours, almost a day. But yeah, and so that's all for this video. Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe, you know, for more videos. And did I say Jada's with her dad? I probably did, but Jada's with her dad, so she won't be ending this video with me. But yeah, we love you guys, and we'll see you next video. And please leave comments down below about what you guys want to see in the near future. Okay? Peace.